Today we are going to discuss about divisibility of roots. See, while you are dividing the number, if our number is given 782 is given, we have to check this number is divisible by 2 or not. Usually what we have to do, first we are writing 782, then we are going like this 2, then 3 2s are 6, remainder 1, then you will carry the remaining 8 down, again 9 2s are 18, remainder 0, you will take the next number down 2, then again you have to write 1 2s are 2, remainder 0. This is how we are checking whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. But using this divisibility rules, you can directly check using the condition whether it is divisible by 2 or not. For example, this is the first one, divisibility of the first condition is, if the ones digit of the number is 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, means that number is surely divisible by 2. For example, I am writing 346. In this one digits, ones digit means this is the ones digit, this is tens digit, this one is hundreds place. So what is the number in ones place? 6. If any of this number is coming in ones place, that number is always divisible by 2. See here, in ones digit place 6 is there. 6 is in this list. So this number, this whole number is divisible by 2. So without doing the actual division, we can understand that if any number ends with 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 means that whole number is divisible by 2. The example is given, is 102 is divisible by 2. So, using this condition, we are checking here. See the last number is 2. 2 is given in this. So, we can say this number is divisible by 2. So, under that, you have to write 102 is divisible by 2. If one number is given, that is 103. We have to check this number is divisible by 2 or not. See the ones place, it is given 3. But in this list, 3 is not given. That means this number is not divisible by, this whole number is not divisible by 2. Okay. So any number ends at 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 means that number will be divisible by 2. Next one, divisibility rule of 3. So how we are doing in divisibility of rule 2, same way we are having one condition here. What is the condition of divisibility rule 3? The sum of digits of is divisible by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 3. For example, is 75 divisible by 3? What is the condition? Sum of its digits. Sum means addition. Its digit means, see, this is one digit, this is one digit. Sum of these digits. So you have to add these two digits. So if you add this one, you will get the answer as 12. 12 is divisible by 3. Yes, you know, 4 3s are 12. So 12 is divisible by 3. So this number is divisible by 3 means this whole number is also divisible by 3. So I am writing here 12 is divisible by 3. So that 75 is divisible by 3. If the sum of this number is divisible by 3, then the whole number is also divisible by 3. The next one, divisibility rule of 4. The number formed by its last two digits is divisible by 4. See, in this one number is given. In this number, you have to check the last two digits. So, this is the given number. We have to check 324 is divisible by 4 or not. See, the last two number. What is the last two number? 24. We have to check 24 is divisible by 4 or not. You know, 5 4s are 20, 6 4s are 24. So 24 is divisible by 4. So that we can say this whole number. What is the whole number? 324. So we can say 324 is divisible by 4. So if one number is given, 936 is given. We have to check this number is divisible by 4 or not. How you will check? You have to see the last two digits. See the last two digits, that is 36. You have to check 36 is divisible by 4 or not. It is divisible by 4 because 9 4s are 36. So 36 is divisible by 4, so that we can say this 936 also divisible by 4. Divisible by 4. Next one, divisibility rule of 5. If any number is given, that number ends with 0 or 5. That means that number will always divisible by 5. For example, here I am writing 1001. In this unit digit, last digit is ends with 5. So we can say this whole number is divisible by 5. If I am writing 763, is this divisible by 5? No, because last digit is 3 is coming. If last digit is 0 or 5, means that number will be divisible by 5. So here one question is given, that is 1050 is divisible by 5. We have to check. So last digit is 0, so we can say this whole number is divisible by 5. Next one is divisible rule of 6. So what is the rule? It is divisible by both 2 and 3. So if any number is given, we have to check the this number is divisible by 6 or not. How you will check? You have to check that number is divisible by 2 or not. Then you have to check that number is divisible by 3 or not. If that given number is divisible by both 2 and 3, we can say that number is divisible by 6 also. So I am giving one example. I am taking 84. We have to check this 84 is divisible by 6 or not. If you have to check that number is divisible by 6 or not, first we have to check that number is should be divisible by 2 and 3. So how you will check the divisibility condition of 2? Divisibility condition of 2 is any number ends at 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 means that is divisible by 2. So see this number, last number is 4. So it's coming in even number. So this number is divisible by 2. So then I am writing last digit is 4. So that this number is divisible by 2. Now we have to check this number 84 is divisible by 3. What is the divisibility of 3 condition? We have to find out the sum of the digits. So I am adding the sum of the digits. I am finding the sum of digits. So you will get 12. 12 is divisible by 3. So we know this number is divisible by 3. So 84 is divisible by 2 as well as divisible by 3. So that we can say 84 is divisible by 6 also. Next one is divisibility rule of 8. So the rule, the number formed by its last 3 digits is divisible by 8. So in the given number we have to check last 3 digits. If that digit is divisible by 8, the whole number will be divisible by 8. See here one question is given, is 3112 is divisible by 8 or not? We have to check whether it is divisible by 8 or not. So what is the condition? You have to take the last 3 digits. What is the last 3 digits in this 112? So we have to check this number is divisible by 8 or not. Yes, this number is divisible by 8. 1 8s are 8. If we subtract 8 from 11, we will get 3. 4 8s are 32. So 4 8s are 32. That means this number is divisible by 8. This 112 is divisible by 8. So the last 3 digits is divisible by 8. Means we can say this whole number is divisible by 8. So I am writing 3112 is divisible by 8. If some other number is given, 7821 is given, we have to check this number is divisible by 8 or not. How we will check? We have to see the last 3 number. We have to check this number is divisible by 8 or not. 1 8s are 8. 2 is small number, so I am adding 10. I am taking 21. 21 is not coming in 8 digits, so you will get the remainder. So this number is not divisible by 8. So we can say this number is not divisible by 8. Next one, divisibility rule of 9. So what is the rule? The sum of its digit is divisible by 9. Sum of digit means you have to add the digits. So 7 plus 6 plus 5, like that you have to add the digits. So now I am going to add the digits. So answer is you will get 18. 18 is divisible by 9 because 2 9s are 18. So 18 is divisible by 9. So that we can say this whole number, that is 765, is divisible by 9. Next one is divisibility rule of 7. So in this one is different from other divisibility rules, because in the previous thing and all we just see the last number, last one digit and last two digit and last three digit in something. are checking, that number itself ends with 0 or 5 or ends with 0, even numbers means that is divisible by 2, we are saying. But in this question, divisibility rule of 7, the rule is the difference between twice its ones digit and the number formed by the other digit is 0 or multiple of 7. For example, this is the given number. We have to check this number is divisible by 7 or not. So, twice of ones digit place. This is the number, ones digit, which number is that? 6. Twice of ones place number. So, twice of means 2 multiplied. Twice means 2. Half means it denotes multiplication in math. So, twice of ones digit number, that is 6. So, I am writing this one. So, difference between. So, difference means you have to subtract. So, what is the remaining number here? 12. So, write the remaining number here. So, write 12 minus twice of unit digit. So, I am writing here like this. So, what will come? 12 minus 2, 6 are 12. Your answer is 12 minus 12, you will get 0. If your answer is 0 or multiple of 7. Multiple of 7 means if your answer here coming 7 or 14, 21. Multiples of 7 also, we can say that number is divisible by 7. If you find the difference between this number and twice of this unit place, your answer will be 0 or multiples of 7 means that whole number is divisible by 7. This 126 is divisible by 7. Here I am getting the answer as 0. That means I can say this 126 is divisible by 7. Now I am going to solve few sums and exercise. In exercise 7, remaining questions are homework for you. First one, circle which of the following numbers are divisible by 3. In this question, they told to only circle the numbers. But how you will circle? First, you have to know the rules. So I am solving everything. Just solve like this in your book. Sorry, your maths register. After that, circle the answer only in your maths book. You have to write the divisibility condition also. You have to write the divisibility condition as well as this exercise 7 in your maths register. Just circle the answer alone in your book. In your book. So first question 108. Divisible of 3. Divisible of 3 condition is you have to find out the sum of the digits. That is divisible by 3 means whole number is divisible by 3. Sum of the digits. This is one digit. This is one digit. This is 3 digit number. You have to add the 3 digits. 1 plus 0 plus 8. 1 plus 0 you will get 1. 1 plus 8 you will get 9. So your answer is 9. 9 is divisible by 3. Yes, 3 3s are 9. So 9 is divisible by 3. If 9 is divisible by 3, we can say this whole number is divisible by 3. So, I am writing here 108 is divisible by 3. Same way, next question 574. Same under divisibility of 3 condition. So, I am going to find out the sum of these 3 numbers. So, I am getting the answer as 16. 16 is not divisible by 3 because it will one remainder will come. So, this is not divisible by 3. So, I am writing 16 is not divisible by 3. So, that the whole number is not divisible by 3. So, I am writing this 574 is also not divisible by 3. Then next number it is given in the question 2072. Again, you have to find out the sum of the digits. So, 2 plus 0 plus 7 plus 3. So, 2 plus 0, you will get 0. 0 plus 7, you will get 7. 2 plus 0, 2. 2 plus 7, you will get 9. 9 plus 3, you will get 12. 12 is divisible by 3. So that we can say this 2073 is also divisible by 3. Next one is divisible by 4 condition. In divisibility of 4 condition, we have to check the last 2 number. So here 2001 is given. In this I am checking last 2 number, that is 01. 01 I can write 1 also. 1 is divisible by 4? No. 1 is not divisible by 4. So that this 2001 is also not divisible by 4. Next I am taking next number 3274. Same condition, we have to check the last 2 number. See 1, 4, 7, 4, remaining 3. So I am keeping 3 here. Thirty-four will not come in fourth table. So this is not, this will So this 74 is not divisible by 4. So that this whole number is not divisible by 4. Next I am taking 4140. Check last 2 digit. This 2 number are not divisible by 4. Sorry, this 9 taking 40. 40 is divisible by 4. 10 4s are 40. So 40 is divisible by 4. So that we can say this 4140 is also divisible by 4. Next, divisibility by divisible by 6 condition. If you check divisible by 6 condition before doing this one, how to check this number is divisible by 2 and 3. So I am taking 162. I am going to check this number is divisible by 2 as well as 3. So last number is 2. If the last number is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 means that number is divisible by 2. So last number here 2 is coming. So that we can write this 160 is divisible by 2. Then 3 condition, we have to add all the numbers. Then that answer is divisible by 3 means the whole number is divisible by 2. So I am going to add this one. I am getting the answer as 9. 9 is divisible by 2. So that I can write this 162 is divisible by 2 as well as 3. So that I can write this 162 also divisible by 6. Okay, so I am writing here. So 162 is divisible by 6. Same way you have to do the remaining questions. Divisible by 7, you know the condition. Apply that condition in this 3 question and find out the answer. Same way divisible condition by 8 and 9. These 3 parts are homework for you. Complete and sum. Thank you, students.